Hey, I was just calling to say that it had nothing to do with you. You didn't change. It was me. I changed. There was nothing you could have done to make me stay. There was nobody else. I left for myself. It's just that, how do I say this? One day, things didn't feel the same. I felt myself drifting away, and my feelings began to wane with each passing day, like a leak that keeps dripping over time. My love for you slowly leaked out of me. I tried to make it work for weeks. I still care for you. I want the very best for you, but I can no longer be there for you. Thank you.
I don't even know what the world is, man. You know, it's just, I don't know. We're all just trying to be okay. And somehow this world has made it kind of tough sometimes.
Making emotional.
Well, God, you know. It's very difficult to understand how demoralized people are.
I get 53, I love living, I don't want to fucking die, I hate the fact that I gotta die now.
What's the motivation?
Just for me, it's to absorb my existence, you know, and realize that life is a joke. I took it too serious.
100%.
You know, not, I don't know, not long after this, I'll die soon, and I won't exist anymore. And then I have to go to the other world, I want to see what that's like. I can't believe this energy that I have just died and it doesn't exist. It may not live here no more, but it has to go somewhere.
100%.
You know? And that's what I'm looking forward to now.
Something never felt kind of okay. I just never felt okay. I always felt like I was trying to make things okay. And things weren't bad. I had some great times. I was fun. I was having fun. But on the inside, I didn't know who I was at all. I didn't have any beliefs. I didn't have any real values.
If you think your life is falling apart, it's not falling apart. It's actually sometimes falling in place, because there were times where in life I thought, and you know, what is there to live for? But I held on, you know.
Not like living in reality. Reality was forget about reality. I have to have a dream. I have to have a goal. I have to get up every morning and go after something. And I believe in the bodybuilding and fitness is makes your life better. But some of the young 20-year-olds, they say things to me like, isn't it really sad, Tom, that you gained all that muscle in the 1980s only to lose it now? Muscle's temporary. It's a temporary thing. So is life. I mean, so is life itself. It's temporary. It's all temporary. Someday, it's going to be your last day. Someday, it's going to be our last day. So I'm going to live every day as if it's my last day and do stuff that I always wanted to do, because I don't want to go, oh man, I'm dying tomorrow, I'm dying now, and I missed it.
Going to the gym. You want success. You want results. You have to do something about it. You just can't hope for it. You can't expect it just to happen because you showed up. You can't just expect it to happen because you did a few of these and a few of those, and you know, you ate some protein and all that stuff. You have to take action. You have to demand it from the universe. You have to demand it from your workouts and insist that it happens right now, here and now. And without that kind of lead up, you're just spinning your wheels. You're not really doing anything. You're just pretending to be some kind of bodybuilder or something like that.
In the fundamentals, properly defined, intensity refers to the percentage of possible momentary muscular effort being exerted. Does anyone require that I state that again? Got it? Now, since the definition I just gave you is rather abstract or technical, in fact, when I first read that definition, I didn't have the slightest clue. What the hell does that mean, I thought. Now I do understand it perfectly. The best way to clarify a highly abstract or technical definition is to go to a concrete example in perceptual reality. You, like any healthy, well-conditioned person, are capable of exerting yourself with a maximum effort at any given moment.
When I was 10 years old, my father died from cancer. And my father died in 30 days. He died. He was just gone like that. 10 years after that, my mother died. Cancer. I just started doing a lot of research on health, how to eat. Because nobody in my family ate right. They would always just eat anything. And then that led me into the gym. And in the gym, I found peace because it was almost like a therapy for myself. I found something that nobody could take away from me. I just took all the passion out into eating, sleeping, and training. I didn't want to go to school or anything like this because all the kids were laughing at me in school because I didn't have a father. But I had that gym, you know, and that gym taught me a discipline, taught me sacrifice, and it just taught me how to trust my decisions.
What really kind of satisfies me in terms of my training isn't necessarily hitting any specific milestone, be it weight, strength, size, whatever. It's more so just, you know, making progress over time, right? The guy who likes walking is going to walk further than the guy who likes the destination. You understand? And that's, it's easy to say, you know, it's easy to say this motivational shit or whatever. It's harder to put it into practice. But, you know, if you go to the gym on a consistent basis for long enough, it's just going to become normal life. It's not going to be a challenge for you to go in. And you should start to see some results coming in.